Life of a radioactive material, what does that mean? If I have a sample of radioactive material, emissions will be there, radiations will be there for some time, and after that time we find there are no radiations or radiations have decreased. We want to have a definition, we want to have a calculation for how much life decay will continue. But the difficulty is that decay is spontaneous, it is not controlled by us. Which nucleus will break, disintegrate, we cannot control. How many will disintegrate, we cannot control. If we cannot control it, then we also do not know that there may be one nucleus which may, we are observing, this may disintegrate after 1 second. Maybe we are watching it, and for 100 years this does not disintegrate. So we never know. So the last particle which will disintegrate may be after infinite length of time, after a very long time. Then it is practically difficult for us to calculate time period or the lifespan. So we have methods of counting the life in two methods, by the two ways. One is the span we measure is by half-life. Half-life of a radioactive material, what does that mean? At present I have a sample which has got 100 nucleus. After 2 years I find the particles, the nucleus have become 50. Half of the nucleus have disintegrated. How much time it has taken? 2 years. So I say 2 years is the half-life of this material. Okay, I take material B. There I have 1000 nucleus bundle. After 1 year, I find this 1000 has become 500. 500, half of the material have disintegrated. So I say 1 year is the time for disintegration of half of the material. So 1 year is it half-life. Now there is a very interesting thing about the half-life. Say one sample has got 16 nucleus. Okay. After 20 seconds they become 8. So how much is the half-life? 20 seconds. Now this 8 will become 4. Will it be very fast? Answer no. It will again take 20 seconds. Here how much is the disintegration? 16 to 8. 8 numbers have disintegrated in 20 seconds. And here 4 numbers have disintegrated in 20 seconds. Now again I wait for 20 seconds and I see the numbers are only 2. How many disintegrated? 2. And in next 20 seconds, how many disintegrated? 1. Why? For the first it was 4. For the second 20 seconds it was 2. Third. It is not a new thing. We know that disintegration depends upon the number of nucleus left. But the half-life, see the wonder. It will become half and it will become half. Therefore 20 seconds is the half-life for this chain. So please remember this method, this is very important. You take any number, if I say my number is 12, when will it become 6? 20 seconds, half. When 8 or when 4 will become 2? 20 seconds. Any quantity that will take 20 seconds to become half. This is half-life. Now when we do for the calculation, first thing we write half-life as T half. And when we go by this relation, put n is equal to n naught divided by 2. Half n naught, then we get the value of t, and this t is log 2 upon lambda. You can do it, it is a very small mathematics. So this is half-life, and half-life formula is log 2 by lambda or 0.693 upon lambda. Please remember this. This is one type of life we calculate in radioactive material, and this tells us how fast it is going to decay. Now, the second type. The second type is average life. Average life, and we give it a notation tau. What is meant by average life? I told you, we are seeing one sample. This particular may disintegrate in 1 second. This one may disintegrate after 100 years. So, there is an average life of that material. Life of particle number 1 plus life of particle number 2 plus life of particle number 3. So, n particles are there. Life of all the n particles, add them, do the addition and divide it with n. So, life of n particles, which are the particles at any time, divided by n, gives the average life tau. And this, we have done the calculation, we have found that this tau is equal to 1 upon disintegration constant. You can also do that. So, tau is 1 upon lambda. So, please remember this. This is the value of average life, and this is the value of half life. Both are related, yes, we can relate them. How much 1 upon lambda equal to? 1 upon lambda here is equal to tau, and in that case equal to, this is 1 upon lambda is equal to t half by 0.693, t half by 0.693. This is the relation between the two. Or you can simply say t half is equal to tau log 2. This is easy to remember. Half-life is tau into 0.6. So, naturally, half-life is less than the average life. Has to be there. So, this is the relation, and these are the two types of life we calculate in radioactive material. Thank you.